Staying organized is tough work. You clean up your car or your house, and moments later, or maybe a few days, it's chaos all over again. Why is that? Well, you might want to blame physics, because this has to do with the second law of thermodynamics, which says the disorder of the world is constantly increasing. But really, personally, as a physics teacher, I'd like to blame math, because it's really a function of statistics, of probability. You see, if you clean up your room, there's one very specific place your clothes can go, in the closet. But if you just randomly throw your clothes into your room, they're very likely to end up in a disorganized position. You see, there's only one spot we would call organized, and many spots we would call disorganized. And that's really at the core of this second law of thermodynamics. Let's get these thoughts ordered in your brain and learn about the second law of thermodynamics. Let's begin by reviewing our lesson objectives. First, we'll introduce the second law of thermodynamics. Then, we'll define entropy. And lastly, we'll explain how entropy changes can be negative. Okay, well, what does the second law of thermodynamics say? It says the entropy of the universe is constantly increasing. Let's give an example. Here we have a lovely sandcastle. Probably took a lot of work to get it this way. And it's in a very highly structured, highly ordered setup. If I move the sand at random, it's going to basically just destroy the castle, not make a new or better one. And over time, what we know is that the disorder of this sandcastle will increase until it looks like this, until all of that intricate structure is gone. And that's just what tends to happen. That's what the second law of thermodynamics is saying. We go from states that are highly ordered, like this castle, to states that are disordered, like this sand. Now, entropy is just a measure of disorder. So, how should we understand this entropy thing in a little more detail? The question you want to ask is, how many arrangements do we have? If there's more possible arrangements, we have more entropy. What exactly do I mean there? Well, let's go back to our castle. This is a very specific arrangement. If I move things, I no longer have my same castle, or I've destroyed my castle. And so we say this is low entropy. There's not very many arrangements of sand that could make this castle. Now, this is high entropy. Why? Because if I move sand from one spot to another, I still have the same state, sand smeared out on the beach. All right, let's give an example closer to home. Perhaps this is how your office looks right now, or your bedroom. It's a mess. Here, there are many possible arrangements. If I took something in that room and moved it at random, it would be in the same state, dirty, messy, disordered. And so because there's many possible arrangements, it's high in entropy. Compare that to this delightful closet. I wish this is what my closet looked like, but sadly it does not. Here, there are few possible arrangements. If I move some of the shoes from one spot to another, or a belt onto the ground, or one of those shirts to a different spot, I'm going to make it less organized. So there's one very specific arrangement which looks like this. So it is low entropy. Let's move on from these household examples to something a bit more sciencey. Let's talk about phase. Entropy depends on phase. So we've talked about solids, liquids, gases, and plasmas. Which one of those has the most clearly defined structure? Which one looks the most ordered to you? It's the solid. And the least ordered turns out to be the plasma. So as we go from solid to liquid, we increase in entropy. And as we go from liquid to gas, we increase in entropy again. Actually, this increase is very large because gases spread out so much compared to liquids. And as we go from gas to plasmas, we once again increase in entropy. Entropy doesn't just depend on phase, it depends on temperature. So, for example, as I go from those low temperature atoms represented in blue to the high temperature atoms represented in red, I increase in entropy. Why is that? Well, the low temperature atoms shake around just a little, whereas the high temperature atoms shake around a lot. And so the high temperature atoms sample a bunch of different possible arrangements, and they're in a less tightly structured situation. So the high temperature stuff is higher in entropy. So increasing temperature increases entropy. All right, let's now go all the way back to reading the second law of thermodynamics. It says the entropy of the universe is constantly increasing. That means things are generally going from structured to less structured. We can state this mathematically with this expression. delta S of the universe is greater than zero. Remember that Greek letter, that triangle there, means change. And S, believe it or not, stands for entropy. I know that's a little strange, but S is the variable we use for entropy, and that's because E is already taken for energy. So we have to come up with something else to mean entropy, so we use S. So delta S of the universe is greater than zero. That means that the entropy of the universe is increasing. It's always positive. All right, well, with that in mind, let's take a look at an example where entropy seems to be decreasing. Here we have a room that's messy and we're cleaning it up. Isn't that decreasing entropy? It's important to remember that this law, which says the change in entropy is greater than zero, applies to the universe as a whole. And so though this room is getting a little neater, there's other ways in which entropy is changing that may be increasing even more than the room is decreasing. Whoa, let's slow that down and explain that a bit, huh? Basically, what we're saying is entropy can decrease in some ways. That's okay. It doesn't violate the second law, so long as it increases in others. Okay, so here, when we're cleaning up our room, think about what's happening. You're actually doing work to clean up the room. You're burning energy as you do that. Your body temperature will increase slightly and it will warm the air around you. That actually more than offsets any increase in order you have from cleaning the room. So though this might look like a decrease in entropy, if we take into account all the factors, you're still increasing entropy as you clean a room. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have an iceberg. And in order to understand more clearly this trade-off between entropy increasing in some places and decreasing in others, we need to clearly define some terms that we've already sort of started to use in this class. One is the system. The system is just the thing we're studying. So let's say in this case, we want to study the iceberg. It's surrounded by a bunch of stuff, and we'll call that the surroundings. So we have a system, the iceberg, and the surroundings. If I put all of those together, I have the universe. In this case, the system right now is lower in entropy. Why is that? Well, remember that it's solid right now, whereas the surroundings are higher in entropy because it's a liquid. So remember, entropy can decrease in some ways so long as it increases in other ways. And now that we've introduced system and surroundings, we can understand that a little more clearly. The change in entropy of the universe is equal to the change in entropy of the system plus the change in entropy of the surroundings. So taken as a mathematical equation, there are a number of ways we can get delta S universe being positive. The second law just says the entropy change of the universe must be positive. But we could, for example, have a negative change in entropy of the system with a much more positive change in entropy in the surroundings, such that delta S of the universe is still positive. Okay, again, let's go back to a practical example. The iceberg melts. So let's think about now that our iceberg is gone and all of that frozen water has gone to liquid water. Let's think about what happened to our surroundings. As the iceberg melted, the surroundings cool. So what does that mean about the entropy change for the surroundings? Well, it's actually negative. The entropy of the water around the iceberg decreased because it cooled. And remember, colder things are lower in entropy. On the other hand, the system, which we said was the iceberg, the system melts. So what does that mean about the entropy? Well, the phase goes from solid to liquid. And remember, that's an increase in entropy. So even though one of those is negative and one of those is positive, they can offset so that delta S of the universe is still greater than zero. When we add together the entropy change of the system and the entropy change of the surroundings, it has to be greater than zero. All right. So in this case, the ocean water decreases in entropy, but the iceberg water increases more. This is kind of like if you get a big paycheck today, you can still go spend some money and you're going to end up with more money than you started with. So the amount of money you have is still increasing, even though you did spend some. Same thing here. The ocean water is decreasing in entropy, but the iceberg water increases in more. So it's still following that second law of thermodynamics. All right, let's practice. In this case, it says, determine if the entropy change is positive or negative. In each case, the system being considered is underlined. So for example, in A, it says a balloon is heated by sunlight. So we're thinking about that balloon. Does the balloon itself increase or decrease in entropy? Or in B, it says water freezes. So we're considering just the water. All right, so pause the video and see if you can predict in each of these cases if the entropy change is positive or negative. Let's review the answers. For A, a balloon is heated by sunlight. That means the balloon is increasing in temperature, and so the entropy is going to increase. For B, we have water freezing. Remember, that means it's going from a liquid to a solid. It's going from liquid, which is relatively high in entropy, to a solid, which is relatively low in entropy, and that means that we're experiencing a decrease in entropy. Remember, that's not delta S of the universe, that's just delta S of the system. Delta S of the universe always has to be positive. For C, water condenses on cold glass. So here, water is condensing. That means going from a gas to a liquid. And so since it's going from gas, which is relatively high entropy, to a liquid, which is relatively low entropy, it's decreasing in entropy. D is food cools after being placed in a fridge. The temperature is decreasing, so our entropy is decreasing. E, sand art is ruined by shaking the bottle. Have you ever seen sand art? It's where you make those cool patterns in a glass bottle by layering sands of different colors. Well, you have a nicely structured sand art in your bottle, and then when you shake it, it's no longer nicely structured. So that's a positive change in entropy. F, a room warms from the heater. Well, since the room temperature is increasing, our entropy change must be positive. Let's review what we've learned. First, we introduced the second law of thermodynamics, where we saw that it says the entropy of the universe is constantly increasing. Then we defined entropy, where we saw that entropy is just a measure of disorder, and the more disordered something is, the higher the entropy. Lastly, we explained how entropy changes can be negative. That's probably the most complicated part of this lesson, but the basic point is the entropy change of the universe has to be positive, but some small local pockets can decrease in entropy, as long as the things around it increase in entropy by more. Hey, hey.